What effect does a vegan diet have on your health? Specifically, what effect does a vegan diet have on your health during the COVID-19 pandemic, if you even work in a hospital? Well, our director of clinical research, Dr. Hana Kahleova, and her colleagues set out to answer that very question. How important is nutrition, especially right now during the COVID-19 pandemic? Does it affect the outcomes? Well, let's find out and welcome our director of clinical research, Dr. Hana Kahleova, back to the exam room. Dr. Kahleova, thank you so very much for being here.
Thanks for having me, Chuck.
This is a really interesting study that you and your team have put together. And initially, I don't even think that you guys, correct me if I'm wrong, were thinking about COVID-19 when you put this study together. It just, the timing just kind of worked out that you had a really, really, really interesting study come out of it that fits hand in hand with the pandemic.
That's correct, Chuck. We wanted to improve the health of the healthcare workers at the Sibley Memorial Hospital in one of the hospitals in DC. And we were surprised when the COVID-19 pandemic hit. And in fact, it was also responsible for some of the disruptions, you know, that we experienced during the study. But we were able to navigate those and we were able to continue the study anyway.
Well, let's talk about the study. Hospital workers. So are we talking doctors, nurses? Who are we talking here?
Yeah, all hospital employees. It includes doctors, it includes nurses, but also some office staff and some support staff, like everyone who works in the hospital.
All right, well, let's dive into the results. I'm going to pull up on the screen for everybody a wonderful presentation that you have put together. So walk us through some of these results in the study.
Yeah, thank you, Chuck. So this is Sibley Memorial Hospital, and our team set out on a quest to just improve the health of the healthcare workers at Sibley Memorial Hospital. We know that it's important to take care of our healthcare workers because the cardiovascular disease rates are on the rise in healthcare workers to about the similar degree as in general population. And we also know that the healthcare workers' health directly impacts the health of their patients and the level of care they're able to provide to their patients. And especially during a time like this, during the COVID-19 pandemic, we know that cardiovascular disease and obesity and type 2 diabetes are all risk factors for increased mortality from COVID-19. And so the healthcare workers that were on the front lines and were risking their lives on an everyday basis, they needed our help the most. And we know from previous studies that plant-based diets really improve all of these aspects. They've been shown to reverse heart disease. They've been shown to be helpful with weight loss and in reversing diabetes. And so why would we not try it out in this population of healthcare workers? This is the paper that has just been published in the American Journal of Lifestyle Medicine. Our original plan was to go to the hospital and do lunch and learn sessions on every Friday. So the hospital, we started working with the cafeteria in the hospital to prepare healthy vegan lunches so that we could spend an hour together eating a healthy lunch and educating each other on the best ways how to prepare healthy vegan foods, but also why to follow a vegan diet. And this was in January 2020. We did all the baseline assessments. We came to the hospital and we brought a calibrated scale. We took the weight of everyone and the height. And also we measured their blood pressure in a super accurate way, 3 times with a few minutes apart. And then we did all the labs. And so the baseline assessments were rigorous. And we felt so great about starting the study in March. And all of a sudden, the hospital called us and said, due to the COVID-19 pandemic, we need to shut down the hospital for 2 weeks. So why don't we just postpone your classes by 2 weeks? And we said, okay, yeah, that's not a problem. We can wait for 2 weeks. But 2 weeks became actually 3 months. And we started with 30 participants who were willing to do the study. And due to the delay, we lost many of them. This period of time between January and March provided like a control phase where nobody did any dietary changes. So we came in March again, did all the assessments again, and then decided to modify our plan and start the classes over Zoom. So the participants had to do their own grocery shopping, and we started the classes over Zoom, and we had 12 participants who decided to do the vegan classes. The mean age was 53 years in our study group. They were overweight, and most of them were female, and most of them, 67% were Black. You may remember that in the beginning of COVID-19, there were some disruptions in food supply. So we had to navigate those. You know, some of the food items were not available, particularly legumes. You know, people were not able to find the beans and the lentils and the peas. And so there were some challenges, but we were able to navigate all those. And here are the findings. The participants lost 12.6 pounds on average on the vegan diet. Of course, there was no change in body weight during the control phase. Total cholesterol was reduced by 30.7 milligrams per deciliter on the vegan diet with no change during the control phase. LDL cholesterol dropped by 24.6 milligrams per deciliter. Fasting blood sugar dropped nicely by 11.4 milligrams per deciliter on the vegan diet. Systolic and diastolic blood pressure were reduced nicely on the vegan diet. And also the quality of life improved significantly on the vegan diet. So in spite of the COVID-19 pandemic, we improved the quality of life of the healthcare workers. And we just cannot highlight enough how important it is to take care of health of our healthcare workers who are on the front lines, risking their lives. And their health is just on the line all the time. And their health also affects their ability to take care of their patients. So we're excited that we were able to support the healthcare workers' health during a time like this. We're excited about the improvements that this may have had on the patient care also. And if you're interested, there will be two testimonials that will be posted together with this video also from our study participants.
Wow. The timing of this, I mean, just quite remarkable. Were you, I guess, there have not really to date that I know of, at least while you were conducting this study, there had not been any research done on the effect of someone's diet in particular on their outcomes for COVID-19. But I do think that based off of everything that we know about the comorbidities, the fact that these healthcare workers, these hospital workers switched over to a plant-based diet, should they have become infected with COVID-19, they would have been perhaps in much better shape.
Yeah, exactly. That's exactly right. There are a few more studies showing the benefits of plant-based diets in healthcare workers during the COVID-19 pandemic. One study showed that those who self-reported consuming a plant-based diet were 73% less likely to develop moderate to severe COVID-19 compared to those who reported other dietary patterns. And that was a study in more than 3,000 healthcare workers in six countries, including the US. So the diet definitely affects, the risk of COVID-19 and especially the severity of COVID-19. Another study just pointed out that consuming a lot of fruits and vegetables can reduce the risk of catching COVID-19 of any severity by 9%, which is a moderate reduction, and can reduce the risk of severe COVID-19 by 43%. And that's only consuming fruits and vegetables. So, even people who are on more traditional diets can still experience significant reductions in their COVID-19 risk by just consuming fruits and vegetables.
So not only would what these studies show was a person less likely to become infected, but should they become infected, the likelihood that they have a severe case of COVID-19 was significantly reduced. You said that was 43% less likely to have a severe case?
That's correct. Yes.
Wow. That's pretty impressive. I want to talk to you, though, also about one of the things that you said close to the top of the presentation, Dr. Kahleova, was that a doctor's own health kind of really dictates the course of treatment that they have with their patient. Specifically, I believe you said that if the doctor themselves were overweight, they were less likely to talk to their own patient about being overweight should they be in the overweight or obese category. That to me was really striking. Were you surprised when you learned that?
Yeah, this makes complete sense, right? So if you as a doctor struggle from excess body weight, you just don't feel as eager to recommend a weight loss program to someone who struggles with the same condition, because they can be like, yeah, but what about you, doc? Like, aren't you in the same need of the same weight loss program as I am? So it's been shown that if the doctor is overweight, the likelihood of them recommending a weight loss program for their overweight patients is only 18%. While when the doctor is within the normal body weight range, about 30% of doctors were recommending the weight loss programs for their overweight patients. The physicians are still busy, and the weight loss programs may not be still, on their on the front line or on their radar, or it may not be the most important thing they can think of, especially when the patients come to urgent care. But still, there is a significant difference between the physicians who are overweight or have a normal body weight.
Yeah, and I think that bias actually would work in both ways, both from the patient perspective and from the physician perspective, because as a patient, if your doctor comes in, exactly as you said, and the doctor was struggling with their own weight, the patient's like, well, I don't know. The doctor doesn't seem too healthy to me, perhaps. And that's just a natural bias. That's not to fat shame or anything like that. Mm-hmm. I just think that that's kind of the direction that the human mind goes in a lot of cases like this. Specific though to obesity, when it comes to being a risk factor, a comorbidity, if you will, for COVID-19, how significant of a factor is that?
It's very significant. So the vast majority of the COVID-19 deaths is due to the comorbidities such as obesity and cardiovascular disease and diabetes and chronic lung disease. If you take all the chronic conditions out of the equation, then the COVID-19, is not really such a big threat for people who don't have these chronic conditions. So just improving all the cardiometabolic outcomes in the healthcare workers is really huge for the quality of their life, but also for their cardiovascular health and for their decreased risk of COVID-19.
Yeah. And you look at all of those things. I mean, cholesterol improved during this study, blood pressure improved, blood glucose improved. Mm-hmm. I mean, you're talking about just all of those top comorbidities when it comes to COVID, all improved. So if you put one and one together, I mean, you could come up with a heck of a hypothesis that equals two that says, yeah, I think that you would be in much better shape if you were eating a plant-based diet when it comes to staying healthy throughout the pandemic. This is really interesting. And what kind of, did you put the participants on a specific menu, or did you just give them guidelines as you had in previous studies, or how did you coordinate that?
We provided them with weekly classes and provided all the guidance. We gave them a healthy cookbook and we're sharing some recipes on a weekly basis, but they were cooking for themselves and they were putting their menu for themselves. And so it was not like a prescribed diet, like step by step, like you have to eat oatmeal every single breakfast. It was more about having different choices. It was a low-fat vegan diet. So vegan means no animal products, and low-fat means that the upper fat intake was 20 to 30 grams per day. And those were the only guidelines for the study. So as long as the participants were staying within the guidelines, they were able to eat anything they wanted.
You know, I'd be really interesting to see this study repeated now that things have kind of opened back up and perhaps you could do these in-person classes again. Do you think that you might see results that are even a little bit better than what you had in this particular study if you were able to do these face-to-face visits?
That's a great question. But it looks like the improvements that we saw in this particular study were pretty much comparable to the changes that we see when we conduct in-person classes. So it's a hard question whether we would get even better outcomes with the in-person classes. But it seems like the participants were really appreciative of the Zoom classes and of all the support. You know, it was the only way how we were able to do the support, and they really appreciated it and made the best out of it.
You know, and let's end with this. One of the things that I've learned throughout the time hosting the exam room is that when it comes to being a doctor, a nurse, really any worker in the hospital, you would think that they would be eating the healthiest food possible, but the diet is actually quite atrocious. And so I think that you're kind of teaching skills here that can carry them much further than however long this pandemic is going to last. You're teaching skills here for healthy eating that can kind of last a lifetime.
Absolutely. And that's why it's important to also work with the hospital cafeteria to provide healthy vegan options for the employees, like, you know, throughout the day, so that they're not completely dependent on what they cook at home, but that they can also rely on the cafeteria to provide some healthy meals.
No question about it. Dr. Hana Kahleova, appreciate you being here. As always, you are one of my most scholarly guests. And so I always feel like I learn so much when you come on the show. Thank you once again.
My pleasure. Thank you, Chuck.
If your health IQ is a couple of points higher than it was a few minutes ago, go ahead and like this video or subscribe to the YouTube channel. And to take it even higher, head over to Apple Podcasts or wherever you get your favorite shows. Look for The Exam Room by the Physicians Committee. Hit the subscribe button there as well and help to make your world a healthier place.